American Olympic swimmer Michael Phelps says anti-doping measures have fallen short in a case involving Chinese swimmers ahead of the Paris Games. We have more in this report.
U.S. swimming star Michael Phelps told a congressional panel on Tuesday that anti-doping measures concerning Chinese swimmers have fallen short ahead of the Paris Olympics. Phelps was joined by fellow gold medalist Allison Schmidt, as well as the CEO of the U.S. anti-doping agency, Travis Tygart. They all testified to lawmakers they've lost faith in the World Anti-Doping Agency, WADA, over its lack of reform. Congresswoman Kathy Rogers asked Phelps what stands in the way of competitions being free and fair of illegal drugs.
I think lack of level playing fields, lack of rule following across the board, right? You know, I mean, you heard the schedule that we have to give every hour of every single day. They have to know exactly where we are. USADA knows exactly where we are. And again, we are okay with that. If everybody else is doing that, then that's what I want. Right? I want to be able to stand up to the block with somebody next to me and be like, all right, cool, this is me versus you. It's not me versus you and seven other drugs.
While neither will compete in Paris, Phelps, with 28 medals to his name, is the most decorated Olympian of all time, and Schmidt won 10 medals over four games. In April, WADA confirmed reports that Chinese swimmers tested positive for a banned substance, leading to calls for accountability and fair competition. WADA declined to testify at the Tuesday hearing, citing the focus on the Chinese swimmers' case. Travis Tygart said WADA should have taken immediate action.
They should have immediately provisionally suspended the athletes, take them off the playing field. That's mandatory under the rules. That was not done. WADA has the appeal right when anti-doping organizations like China, in this case, fail to impose a mandatory provisional suspension. WADA should have immediately appealed that, like they did in the Russian figure skater case, if you remember.
Exactly.
She was not provisionally suspended by Russia, surprise, and they appealed that.
Lawmakers of both parties slammed WADA's handling of the situation, calling it unacceptable. Phelps highlighted the impact on his friends affected by the case, saying that many of them will live with the what-ifs for the rest of their lives, and criticized WADA for its inconsistent enforcement of policies around the world.
For former Senator Antonio Trillanes, a claim of Vice President Sara Duterte may just be an attempt to lead the narrative in the run-up to the 2025 elections. He adds the announcement could be a trial to see if the public is perceptive of the idea.
Parang pinapaaga nila yung simula ng election season. Na sa ganun, itong mga ine-expect nila na mga issues against them, bunga ng politika. Kailangan din pong tignan ito in a serious light. Kung ganito ang situation, ano ang counter dito? Mapaangat nila sa survey nila, no? Kunyari, lumabas sa survey by September this year na pasok silang tatlo sa top 12, bakit naman hindi sila tatakbo?
Yeah. Former Senator Panfilo Lacson believes the vice president's announcement is only meant to confuse politicians and keep everyone guessing. He also took note of the growing number of political families in the Senate. Lacson offered a glimpse of what the 2025 Senate could look like with three Dutertes, three Tulfos, and two each of the Villars, Cayetanos, and Estradas. President Marcos urges local governments to boost efforts against hunger. He spoke Wednesday at a palace ceremony to recognize LGUs with best practices on food security. Marcos urged local governments to ensure their anti-hunger programs reach the grassroots level. He also called for a collective approach to the problem. A local survey has found more Filipino families experienced involuntary hunger in the first quarter. Biliran, in the Eastern Visayas region, was a lone province awardee. The 10 LGUs at the awards will each get up to 2 million pesos in cash prize to help their sustainable livelihood programs.
As agents of the government on the ground, our LGUs not only have a better knowledge and have good insights on the incidence of hunger in their localities, but also provide maybe perhaps better programs, better strategies or approaches to address hunger specific to the areas that their constituents lie.